Okay, so what is an ostinato? Technically speaking, the actual definition is a short melody or pattern that is constantly repeated, usually in the same part at the same pitch. You know what an ostinato is. If you've had any involvement in pop music or anything like that, you know it as a riff. It's a riff. When you play a song on a guitar, if it's like a rock song, you've got a riff and it repeats over and over. Not forever, not for the whole thing, but it's very similar to how a riff works, right? Now, an ostinato can be low, or it can be high. It can be right in the middle. It's usually not in a voice part. It's usually in an instrument part. I can't think of an example where I've ever heard an ostinato in a voice part. I'm sure it exists somewhere, but it's not typical. And it's really popular in film music. What we do with an ostinato is we come up with a repeating pattern that's going to work that we like. And then we might add a harmony to it. We might add a melody to it. We might add some percussion to it. But it kind of works as like the canvas of our piece. It's always there. It's always going. You can change it if you want. Like in the first one we watched, in the Captain America one, it changed at one point. But I think the reason that film composers like them so much is that they help you to work fast. And we have to do that a lot when we're writing films. You lay down that ostinato and you've got like the first layer of your entire cue done. You know, then you can just add things to sweeten it up and make it work with the film a little bit better. But a lot of it is done. One example of them that's kind of similar to a riff is, you may have heard this song before. If you know the show House, this song, it's actually a song by a band called Massive Attack. This was used as the theme song in the US. Not in the US, they used a different song for the theme song. They had original score, but this is a great example of an ostinato. You're gonna hear in the harpsichord here, this pattern just repeating all the way through. Like, you hear that. And then soon you're gonna hear a bass line come in that works with all of those notes. So now we have an ostinato and a bass line that works as a repeating chord progression together. All the notes in the bass line work with the ostinato. Now, that doesn't mean that every note in the ostinato is in every chord that we might do with the ostinato. Because we're doing an ostinato, we can actually get away with a little bit more. You have the repeating pattern in your head, and if a chord doesn't perfectly work with the ostinato, because the repeating pattern is in your head, you can kind of create a little bit of tension by having a chord that doesn't totally work. Work is a strange word in this context. It's gonna work. It's just a matter of how dissonant you're willing to let it get. Let's jump into another video where we're gonna write one. Actually, first we're gonna talk really quick about how to get started on a project and some tips for videos, movies that you can score on your own. And then we'll start a project where we're going to use an ostinato. So let's jump into that really quick, and then we'll be back to ostinatos in just a second.